Hey, welcome back, math class. This is Mr. Jacobs, and I'm looking at 5.2 proportions, a new section. How can proportions help you decide when things are fair? Big idea. Use this all the time when I'm shopping. So it says, tell whether the two ratios are equivalent. If they are not equivalent, change the next day to make the ratios equivalent. Alrighty. Explain your reasoning. Okay, so here's what it says. On the first day, you pay $5 for two boxes of popcorn. On the second day, you pay $7.50 for three boxes. Is that the same rate? In other words, is it fair that you paid $5 for two boxes and the next day you pay $7.50 for three boxes? So here's what I do. I'm going to zoom in here for a second. It would be nice to know, and this is the key, it would be nice to know what the unit rate is. What are you paying for one box? So I want to know this answer to this question. Okay, let me turn my music down a little bit. All right, now, hopefully you remember that to make a unit rate, you just take the denominator and divide it by itself. So I'm going to do that. So I'm going to take the boxes here, and I'm just going to just write right over it, guys. Sorry about that. And so I now know that 2 divided by 2 is 1. That's how I get this answer. And 5 divided by 2, what's half of $5? $2.50. So one box costs $2.50. Are you following? Does that make sense? So, knowing that, here's what you can do. You ask yourself, okay, for three boxes, what do I multiply one by? See the concept there? You can divide the fraction to reduce it, or you can multiply it. And again, it's the same fraction, just in a different form, right? You can multiply or divide to keep the fractions equivalent or equal. So what do you multiply? You multiply by. You only multiply by 3. And let's use the that symbol. And therefore, I have to multiply 250 by 3. And let's ask Siri. 2.50 times 3.
The answer is 7.5.
And we have it. So what do we know? We know what we see here are all three fractions are equivalent. And so it's fair. And so I'm just going to erase this so we can see what's going on. We now know that the unit rate, $2.50 per box, is equal to $5 for two boxes. It's also equal for $7.50 for three boxes. It's the same rate of $2.50 per box. Does that make sense? So that's your idea, okay? Now, things get messier. They get messier. And I can, you know, if you wanted to write this out as a input-output table. You can put one box is $2.50. Two boxes is... three boxes is $7.50. So you can actually maybe see patterns there. You can see that you're to go from 2 to 3, you were adding by $2.50. See it? See that? And when you move in the opposite direction, you're subtracting by $2.50, right? So that's another way you can use a table of values to try to figure out, does it seem fair? And yeah, it does. Now, B, it says, on the first day, it takes you 3.5 hours to drive 175 miles. The next day, it takes you 5 hours to drive 200 miles. Are these fractions equivalent? In other words, are you driving the same speed per day, right? And let's try to figure that out. I think It's a good question. So let's take a look at this. Are these equal? Well, you know, you could take, what's your speed? How long does it take to drive a mile? You could do that. And so let's try to analyze this question a little, in a way that makes sense. So, Well, I can do this. Watch this. If I take this amount here, let's change it. You know, and sometimes this is this is oh so confusing sometimes. But what I want to do is I want to write this as miles per hour. So it's 100% okay to take a ratio and flip it. Okay, you can do that as long as you flip this proportion on each side. Alrighty, I didn't write the units of measurement, that's okay. So I'm going to convert the left side, 175 divided by 3.5. I want to find the unit rate. So I'm going to divide by 3.5, okay? Let me ask Siri. 175.
I'm listening.
175 divided by 3.5.
It's 50.
Yeah, there you go. So if I divide and it's just easier to work with decimals, then this is going to be 50 miles every 1 hour. Are you following? So for the sake of room, I'm going to move this over. See what I did? Now the question is, are these equal? Well, let's find out. Let's use red. Multiply 1 hour by 5 equals 5 hours. Now multiply 50 by 5. And that's 250. See, so it looks like you're driving slower because 50 times 5 is 220 or 250. And you only went 200 miles, so you're driving actually a little slower than 50 miles per hour. That is slow, huh? So it says, hey, are they equal? So you would say, you'd have to write on your paper that this is, put a slash mark through it. It means no. Not equal. It means not equal. So they're not equal. Then it says to write the proportion or the proportion that would be equal, right? What would make these two proportions equal, right? Well, if you're a proportion, you are equal. So what would make these two rates equal? And so here it is. So here's the answer you have to also write. 50 miles. Actually, I'll write it this way. It's 175. It's the original. Has to equal 250 miles over 5 hours. That would be your answer. So I hope that makes a little bit of sense. Like I always say, study hard, learn a lot. And we'll see you soon. Bye-bye.